Hi everyone.
Welcome to the online classes DO Nalgonda 10th class mathematics English medium trigonometry. In the previous class we have learned the definition of trigonometry and use of trigonometry, application of trigonometry and what are the trigonometric ratios, how they are defined. So in this class we solve the problems in exercise 11.1. Once again let us revise the trigonometric ratios. There are 6 trigonometric ratios. First one, sin A is equal to opposite side by sin theta is equal to opposite side by hypotenuse, cos theta is equal to adjacent side by hypotenuse, and tan theta is equal to opposite side by adjacent side, cosec theta is equal to hypotenuse by opposite side, sec theta is equal to hypotenuse by adjacent side, and cot theta is equal to adjacent side by opposite side. First one, second one, third one. Here opposite side by hypotenuse, the inverse is cosec theta. Inverse of sin theta is cosec theta. That's why hypotenuse by opposite side cosec theta. Here right angle triangle. You know that ABC. Here opposite to 90 degrees is called hypotenuse. The next, this is some angle theta. Here this side is called adjacent side. Adjacent side to theta angle, this one is hypotenuse, longest side, this is adjacent side to theta, and the opposite side to theta is this one AB, opposite side. If we divide opposite side by hypotenuse, that ratio is called sin theta for this particular angle theta. If we divide adjacent side by hypotenuse, we get a ratio, that ratio is called cos theta for this angle theta. If we divide opposite side by adjacent side, we get tan theta, that is ratio of the opposite side and adjacent side for particular theta angle. For every angle the ratio will be changed. Cosec theta is nothing but inverse or reciprocal of the sin theta, opposite by hypotenuse by opposite side, and sec theta is reciprocal to cos theta, that is hypotenuse by adjacent side, and cot theta is reciprocal of tan theta, like this. So that is adjacent side by opposite side. These are the 6 trigonometric ratios are there here. So in this problem we have to find out sin A and cot tan A when cos A is given. So let us, according to the definition of cos theta, what is cos theta? Adjacent side by hypotenuse. Adjacent side by hypotenuse is called cos theta. So the numerator is taken as adjacent side and denominator is taken as hypotenuse. Let us draw a right angle triangle here. Here angle is A. So we have to take here A angle, here B, and this vertex is C. So opposite side is not given here. So adjacent side to A is this one AB. This is adjacent side. Adjacent means just side by side. Then here is 90 degrees. Opposite to 90 degrees is hypotenuse. Hypotenuse. How to identify adjacent side? Here are two sides to the angle A. The longest side is hypotenuse and the shortest side is adjacent side. Simply we can identify adjacent side. And the opposite to this angle, opposite this angle is called opposite side. Here adjacent side is 12. So right here 12 and hypotenuse is 13. So right here 13. hypotenuse is 13. We have to find out opposite side. Take his side x. We have to find this one. So it is a right angle triangle. To find opposite side or to find adjacent side or to find hypotenuse, we use Pythagoras theorem. According to Pythagoras theorem, hypotenuse square is equal to base square plus height square, or AB square plus BC square is equal to AC square. AB square plus BC square, AB square plus BC square is equal to AC square, or AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. Hypotenuse square of the hypotenuse is equal to sum of the squares of the other two sides. This is Pythagoras theorem. Let us substitute the known values. From that we can find unknown values. Here AB is adjacent side, 12 square is given. BC is equal to, we have taken as x, it is unknown side. So is equal to AC is equal to 13 square. Here 12 square means 144 plus x square, this is 139. 12 to 12, 144. Now x square is equal to 169. Transpose 144 to right side, it becomes minus 144. X square is equal to, this is 25 after subtraction. Then x is equal to square root of 25. Square root of 25 means 5 units. So we got x value. Here x means what? Opposite side. Opposite side is equal to 5 units, and adjacent side is equal to 12 units, and hypotenuse is equal to 13 units. Here 5, 12, 13 makes a right angle triangle. Now write the ratios whatever we required here. We have to write here sin A. According to definition, sin A means opposite side to A, angle A by hypotenuse. Opposite side to angle A, here what you are doing? 5. The hypotenuse is here 13, 5 by 13. So sin A is equal to 5 by 13. See here, this is 5 we got by this simplification, 5 by 13 sin A, 5 by 12 tan A. So tan A is equal to opposite side by adjacent side. Here opposite side 5. Adjacent side 12. In this way we can find any ratio. Here sin A is equal to 5 by 13, cosec A is equal to 13 by 5, reciprocal of sine. Cos A is equal to 12 by 13, sec A is equal to 13 by 12, and tan A is equal to 5 by 12, cot A is the reciprocal of tan, so cot A is equal to 12 by 5. In this way we can find all other trigonometric ratios in this problem. Now let us solve this problem. So next, fifth problem. 3 tan A is equal to 4, then find sin A and cos A. Here ratio is given, but here ratio is not given, but you have to find out sin A and cos A. How? You have some confusion here. Just transpose this 3 to right side, because tan A should be made as object. From this, just one difference is here. Just transpose 3 to right side, tan A is equal to 4 by 3. We have to construct a right angle triangle. Draw a right angle triangle, do not construct. Now here take as A, here B, here C. This is opposite side and this is adjacent side. 90 degrees, opposite to 90 degrees is hypotenuse. Here tan A, we know the definition of tangent theta, that is opposite side by adjacent side. Here opposite side is 4, so we have to write 4 here. Let us write 4. This is 4. Adjacent side is 3, so write 3 here. From that we have to find hypotenuse. According to Pythagoras theorem, we know, according to Pythagoras, theorem, hypotenuse square is equal to, here opposite side square and adjacent side square, other all, according to Pythagoras theorem, hypotenuse square is equal to sum of the squares of the other two sides, sum of the squares of the other two sides. So here BC is equal to 4 square and AB is equal to 3 square. Here 4 square means 16, 3 square means 9, 16 plus 9, 25. AC square is equal to 25. From that we can find AC also. AC is equal to square root of 25. If you know the square of a number, to find square root, keep square root here and find square root, that is equal to 5 units. So let us write all sin A and cos A. Here write opposite side is what here from this figure? 4. And adjacent side is what here? Is 3. And hypotenuse is 5. Hypotenuse is 5 just now. We have found that one. From this we can write whatever you want. Sin A, according to sin A definition, opposite side by hypotenuse. Opposite side by hypotenuse. Your opposite side is 4, hypotenuse is 5. Your cos A is equal to adjacent side by hypotenuse. Adjacent side by hypotenuse. So adjacent side by hypotenuse, that is equal to 3 by 5. So in this, from this we can cut a conclusion. Sin theta and cos theta values is always a proper fraction, because hypotenuse is more than opposite side, therefore hypotenuse, your denominator is always more than numerator. Always more than numerator, because hypotenuse is the longest side in the triangle. Therefore, hypotenuse is more than always adjacent side and opposite side. That's why if in the fraction, if numerator is less than denominator, it is called proper fraction. This is the proper fraction. So, sin theta value is always less than 1. Cos theta value also always less than 1. This should not be improper fraction. So in this way we can find unknown trigonometric ratios. Ikkada manaku endante cos theta ichindu, sin theta ka tan theta ganukovali. Ikka sin cos ante em bayapadevalsina avasaram ledhu, oka ratio maatrame ante side ku ee side ni oka side tho divide chesthe oka number ostundi. Aa number ni dani oka side lanu batti manamu sin theta cos theta antamu. Ikkada manaku cos theta 12/13 ichindu. 13/12 ante emo adjacent side, 13 అంటే ఏమో హైపోటెనస్. సో ఇక్కడ రైట్ యాంగిల్ ట్రయాంగిల్ డ్రా చేసుకోండి. అందులో ఇది ఏమో యాంగిల్ ఏ, ఇది ఆపోజిట్ సైడ్, ఇది 2 ద టీటా యాంగిల్ ఏ ఆ టీటా. బీసీ ఈజ్ ద అడ్జసెంట్ సైడ్ అండ్ ఏసీ ఈజ్ ద హైపోటెనస్. అడ్జసెంట్ సైడ్ ఈజ్ 12, సో ఇక రైట్ ఇయర్ 12, హైపోటెనస్ ఈజ్ 13, రైట్ ఇయర్ 13. ఫ్రమ్ దిస్ ఫైండ్ ద అన్నోన్ సైడ్ దిస్ వన్ బై యూజింగ్ అకార్డింగ్ టు పైథాగరస్ థీరం. పైథాగరస్ థీరం ప్రకారంగా మనం కనుక్కుంటాము. పైథాగరస్ థీరం ఒకటి పైథాగరస్ ఉంది, ఏసీ స్క్వేర్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు ఏబీ స్క్వేర్ ప్లస్ బీసీ స్క్వేర్. నేను రైట్ యాంగిల్ ట్రయాంగిల్ మాత్రమే వర్తిస్తుంది. సో ఒక ఏబీ స్క్వేర్ అంటే 12 స్క్వేర్, బీసీ స్క్వేర్ అంటే ఎక్స్ స్క్వేర్. ఇక్కడ నుంచి మీరు ఎక్స్ స్క్వేర్ని మీరు సబ్జెక్ట్ చేయండి, చేస్తే ఇక్కడ 225 వచ్చింది, అక్కడ నుంచి ఏ 5 వస్తుంది. ఆ 5ని ఇక్కడ మళ్ళీ క్లియర్గా రాసుకోండి. ఆపోజిట్ సైడ్ ఎంత, అడ్జస్టెంట్ సైడ్ ఎంత, హైపోటెనస్ ఎంత రాసుకొని मन का ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक रेशियो एवाले सैन ए टैन ए रास्को सैन एज इक्वल टू आपोजिट साइड बाय हाइपोटेन्यूस रायें 5/13 सी आर 5/13 सिमिलरली टैन एज इक्वल टू आपोजिट साइड बाय एडजेसेंट साइड आपोजिट साइड 5 एडजेसेंट साइड 12 5/12 ई विधंगा मीरु तेलुसुकोंडि 3 टैन एज इक्वल 4 इक्कड फ्राक्षन इव्वलेदु इव्वकुंटे इक्कड ना नंबर उंटुंदि दानि ट्रांस్పోజ్ చేయండి అప్పుడు ఫ్రాక్షన్ అయిపోతుంది ఆ తర్వాత మొత్తం దీనిలాగానే చేస్తాం సేమ్ ఏది తెలుదో తెలుసుకొని చేస్తాం ఇక్కడ ఆపోజిట్ సైడ్ టాన్ తీటా కాబట్టి ఇది ఆపోజిట్ సైడ్ ఇది అడ్జసెంట్ సైడ్ ఇది ఆపోజిట్ సైడ్ 4 అడ్జసెంట్ సైడ్ 3 వి హావ్ టు ఫైండ్ అవుట్ హైపోటెనస్ హైపోటెనస్ x గా తీసుకొని ఫైండ్ అవుట్ చేద్దాం హైపోటెనస్ స్క్వేర్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు సమ్ ఆఫ్ ది స్క్వేర్స్ ఆఫ్ ది అదర్ టు సైడ్స్ అంటే 4 స్క్వేర్ ప్లస్ 3 స్క్వేర్ 4 స్క్వేర్ ప్లస్ 3 స్క్వేర్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు 25 దెన్ ac ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు స్క్వేర్ రూట్ ఆఫ్ 25 ఈజ్ 5 ఫ్రమ్ దిస్ వి కెన్ ఫైండ్ టాన్ a ఆపోజిట్ సైడ్ బై హైపోటెనస్ 4/5 cos a అడ్జసెంట్ సైడ్ బై హైపోటెనస్ 3/5 ఈ విధంగా మనము ఒక ట్రయాంగిల్ వేసుకొని ఇలాంటి వాల్యూస్ ఇచ్చి వేరే అనుకోండి అంటే ట్రయాంగిల్ వేసుకొని నోన్ సైడ్స్ రాసేసి అన్నోన్ సైడ్స్ పైథాగరస్ థీరం ద్వారా తెలుసుకోవాలి దాని నుంచి మనం ఏది కావాలంటే అది సైన్ కాస్ టాన్ టాన్ కాట్ ఏదైనా కనుక్కోవచ్చు Next, let us solve the first problem of the exercise 11.1. ABC is a right angle triangle. 8 cm, 15 cm, 17 cm are the lengths of AB, BC, CA respectively. Then find out sin A, cos A, tan A. Here, what is respectively here? 8, 15, 17 are lengths of AB, BC, CA means 8 cm, AB is equal to 8 cm, BC is equal to 15 cm, CA is equal to 17 cm. We have to take in serial. Therefore, let us take AB is equal to 8 cm, BC is equal to 15 cm, and CA is equal to 17 cm. Then we have to find out sin A, cos A, tan A. So, let us draw a triangle here. Now, where is the right angle is located here? Right angle triangle, where is the right angle here? AB, BC, CA. Where is the right angle here? CA. CA is the largest side. So, right here C, either A, or here A, C, either A. This is the vertex C, A, and remaining one B is the right angle triangle. It is 17 cm CA. The largest side is taken as 18, 15, 17. Among these three sides, largest side 17, that is taken as hypotenuse. And remaining sides AB 8, this is 8 centimeters, BC 15, this is 15 centimeters. Now find whatever you are required. Sin A, here sin A is equal to opposite side by hypotenuse according to sin theta definition. Here this is A, here A means A opposite side to A, this one opposite side to A, that is 15 by hypotenuse, this hypotenuse is fixed, hypotenuse this is 17 over, that's all. Opposite to side C is 8 centimeters, adjacent side to C is 15 centimeters, opposite side to A is 15 centimeters. Adjacent side to A is 8 centimeters, but C or A, if you take any angle, hypotenuse is 17 only. Next, cos A. Cos A, we know definition cos A, adjacent side by hypotenuse. Cos A is equal to adjacent side by hypotenuse. What is adjacent side A? Adjacent side to A is 8 centimeters by hypotenuse 17. There are no, if you write here centimeters and centimeters, they will get cancelled. Again, you will get 15 by 17 only. It is a ratio, it has no units, only ratio. Then tan A is equal to opposite side by adjacent side. So here opposite side to A is 15 and adjacent side is 8, 15 by 8. In this way we have to find out the required trigonometric ratios. Here, let us solve one more question here. Second question. The sides of a right angle triangle PQR are PQ 7, PR 25, angle Q is equal to 90 degrees. Here, angle is given. We can write angle Q 90. But here, angle is not given. So, we have to think about the which is the longest side, that is CA. Other than C and A, there is one more vertex is here, that is B. At B, right angle is located. Here, let us draw the triangle again. Q is 90 degrees. Here, PR, PQR. Now, here, PQ is equal to 7 centimeters. QR is not given here. So, PR is 25 centimeters. QR is not given. Take it as X. PQ is equal to 7 centimeters, PR is equal to 25 centimeters, and QR is equal to take X, let X centimeters. Then what you have to find here? Tan P minus tan R. Tan P minus tan R. First, to find this tan P tan R, we should find the adjacent side to R. You have to find the X. In a right angle triangle, according to Pythagoras theorem, we know that PQ square plus QR square is equal to PR square. PQ square is equal to 7 square, QR square is equal to X square, PR square is equal to 25 square. 7 square means 49, this is X square. 25 to 25, 625, then X square is equal to 625 minus 49, X square is equal to 576, X square is equal to 576. Then how to find X? You know how to find X? How to find the square root of 576. We know how to find square root of 576, we have learnt in the 9th class by division method. 2 bar on 2 rhombus, only 5 is there, now take only 1, 2 2 is 4, by subtraction 1, 7, 6, bring down 2 numbers at a time, 2 plus 2, 4, now which number comes here, 44, 4 ja, 4 4 ja, 16, 1, 4 by 16 plus 1 17. We have already learned the process how to find the square root of 576. So we got here tan P minus tan R. This is we have to find. So here we have already know the value of the PQ, that is 7, QR 24, hypotenuse 25. Here tan P means what? Opposite side to angle P by adjacent side to angle P minus opposite side to angle R by adjacent side to angle R. Opposite side to P, P means what? 24 by adjacent side to P 7, opposite side to P means 24, just behind the adjacent side to P is equal to 7 minus opposite side to R, R ki opposite side 7 by adjacent side, R ki adjacent side 24. Put LCM diskundam rendit ki 7 ki 29 LCM 7 into 24, because it is a prime number, it is a composite number. LCM we get the product of these two numbers. Now divide the numbers by 7. 7 into 24. Divide LCM by denominator. We will get 24. This 24 into numerator 24. 24 into 24. Again we get 576. 24 into 24. Minus here 7 into 24 by 24 cancel 7. That means divide LCM by denominator, you will get a quotient 7, multiply that quotient with the numerator, 24 जा 576 माइनस 77 जा 49 बाय 24 इंटू 7 7 4 जा 28 7 जा 14 प्लस टू 16 बाय सब्ट्रैक्शन 16 माइनस 9 7 फिर 6 माइनस 4 टू फिर 527 बाय 168 दिस इज द वैल्यू ऑफ टैन पी माइनस टैन आर. So adjacent side and opposite sides are not fixed. Just we have to take them according to the angle. Angle opposite to R, angle means 7, adjacent to R is 24. Opposite to P is 24, adjacent to P is 7. In this way you have to take and substitute in the values, find the answer. Next, given cot theta is equal to 7 by 8, then evaluate 1 plus sin theta into 1 minus sin theta by 1 plus cos theta into 1 minus cos theta. This is one more question here. So first of all, we have to find sin theta, cos theta. Tan theta is given here. From this, we have to find sin theta, cos theta values. Here are two questions. There are two questions only. First question, second question. Where question will be? First question, chedam mundu. Ikkada first, indulo cot theta ichindu. Cot theta. You know, this is theta. Take ABC. This is opposite side to theta. Opposite side. Theta means any angle. Here this is adjacent side and this is hypotenuse. In this triangle, cot theta is equal to 7 by 8. We know the definition of cot theta. That is adjacent side by opposite side. So adjacent side is 7. Adjacent side is 7, opposite side is 8. Adjacent side is 7, opposite side is 8. From this we have to find hypotenuse. We know that according to Pythagoras theorem, AC square is equal to BC square plus AB square. AC square is equal to BC square means 7 square plus AB square, 8 square. Here 7 square means 49, 8 square means 64. By adding this, 113. So AC square is equal to 113. AC square is equal to 113. Then what is AC? We have to find square root 113. 113. It is not a perfect square. So leave it as this. Then AC is equal to 113 means AC means hypotenuse. So the hypotenuse opposite side to C, AB opposite side, that is equal to 8. BC adjacent side, that is equal to 7. And AC is equal to hypotenuse, HYP means hypotenuse, ADJ adjacent opposite side, root 113. From this square root of 113, from this we write sin theta. What is sin theta? According to definition, sin theta definition, opposite side by hypotenuse. Opposite side is here what? 8 by hypotenuse 113. Then cos theta is equal to adjacent side by hypotenuse, that is equal to adjacent side means what here? 7 by root 113. Now we have to find that 1 plus sin theta into 1 minus sin theta. 1 plus sin theta into 1 minus sin theta by 1 plus cos theta into 1 minus cos theta. Here 1 plus sin theta into a plus b into a minus b formula. So we get here a plus b into a minus b, a square minus b square. By here also a plus b into a minus b, a square minus b square, 1 square minus cos square theta. Here let us substitute. 1 square means 1 sin theta, 1 minus sin square theta by 1 minus cos square theta. Sin theta into sin theta, sin square theta. Cos theta into cos theta, cos square theta, not cos theta square, not sin theta square. Here substitute the values 1 minus sin theta value 8 by root 113 by 1 minus cos theta value, what is called 7 by root 113. Again we take LCM here, let us take LCM. Here one root 113 is the LCM, but here we have to do square is there, so we have to do the square. Here also you have to do the square. Now here 1 minus 8 square, 64, square root of 113 whole square means 113, by 1 minus 7 square, 49, square root of 113 whole square, 113. So yes, a by b whole square is equal to a square by b square formula. So here 113, in the numerator 113, 113 LCM, 113 1 jam 113 minus 64. In the denominator 113, 113 into 1, 113 minus 49. Here 113 minus 64 is equal to 9, 10 minus 6 is equal to 4. 113, 113 numerator, denominator is same, so this way, that's why cancel, we can cancel it. Otherwise, we can do one more step. Here, 49 by 113 whole by here 4 and 10 minus 4, 7. 7, 10 minus 4, 6. Here, 16 by 113. Fraction by fraction, we got fraction by fraction. How to divide fraction by fraction? So write first fraction as it is and multiply with reciprocal of the second fraction. Reciprocal means reverse, like this. Both gets cancelled. 49 1 49 by 64. This is the value of 1 plus sin theta into 1 minus theta by 1 plus cos theta into 1 minus cos theta. So in this way we find the value. This one, there is second problem in this bit, we have to try yourself that problem. Now let us find the value of sin a cos c plus cos a sin c when tan a is equal to root 3 is given. In a right angle triangle ABC, right angle is at B. If tan a is equal to root 3, then find the value of sin a cos c plus cos a sin c and cos a into cos c minus sin a into sin c. I will solve this problem. You will try yourself this one. Then sin a cos c plus cos a into sin c, here into is there. To find this one, sin theta and cos theta, you have to find that from this tan a, you have to find out sin a and cos c. Let us write here, draw a right angle triangle, and here right angle is at B. This you have to keep in your memory. What is given here? Right angle is at B. So here then tan A is equal to root 3. Root 3. Tan theta means opposite side to A. Let us write A here and C here. Opposite side to angle A by adjacent side to angle A is equal to root 3. So denominator is not there, write 1 here. Opposite side to A is equal to root 3. Opposite side A, this is BC. This is BC. And adjacent side to angle A means AB. So this is required angle. So this is root 3 and this is 1. From this we have to find hypotenuse. So AC square is equal to, according to Pythagoras theorem, AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. Here AB square means root 3 whole square and BC square, AB square is equal to 1 square and BC square is equal to root 3 square. This is 1, root 3 square means 3, 1 plus 3, 4. AC square is equal to 4, then AC is equal to square root of 4, that is equal to 2. So here we got the hypotenuse 2. From this we can find sine, cos, tan, whatever we required. So I will write here
the figure, here A, B, C. C is 90 degrees, here 1, this is root 3, this is 2. From this sin A cos C, cos A sin C. See here, opposite side to angle A is root 3 and adjacent side to angle A is equal to 1. That is equal to BC, this is equal to AB. But opposite to angle C, opposite side to angle C is 1, that is equal to BA or AB. Adjacent side to angle C is root 3 and hypotenuse is same. Hypotenuse, that is AC, is equal to 2. From this we have to select the ratios. Sin A cos C, sin A into cos C plus cos A sin C. See here, sin A means opposite side by hypotenuse, sin theta opposite side by hypotenuse, and that means root 3 by 2, opposite side to hypotenuse. C cos C, C is here opposite adjacent side to C by hypotenuse, adjacent side to C is root 3 by hypotenuse is 2. This is opposite side to A by hypotenuse, opposite side to A root 3 hypotenuse. Cos A adjacent side to A 1 by hypotenuse 2 into sin C opposite side to C 1 by hypotenuse 2, opposite side by hypotenuse. Root 3 into root 3 square, we will get 3, 2 into 2, 4. Here 1 into 1, 1, 2 to 4, by adding these like fractions, you can add 3 plus 1, 4, 4 by 4 means 1, the answer is 1. Similarly, we can do this one also, cos A, cos C minus sin A, sin C. Cos A, adjacent side to A is 1 by hypotenuse 2 into adjacent side to C is root 3 by 2. Here opposite side to A root 3 by hypotenuse, this is C, opposite side to C 1 by hypotenuse. Here root 3 into 1 root 3, 2 2 ja 4 minus root 3 into 1 root 3, 2 2 ja 4, root 3 by 4 minus root 3 by 4, you will get 0. In this way, just take care whether deciding the opposite side, adjacent side. Opposite side to A means root 3, adjacent side to A means 1. Opposite side to C is 1, adjacent side to C is root 3, but hypotenuse is same. In this way, take care by substituting your values. Okay.